tell the patient, don't do this, don't do that. If you're a patient like me, I'll say, oh, doctor, ko chhod do, dusre ko pakdo. It will be like that. Don't say no, because you want that the patient should have full faith and confidence in you. You are going to be telling, I tell my patient, there is no need for you to go in for chemotherapy, this, 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 this. But because the patient has already gone there, and then come to you, or vice versa, or sometimes they go there for their diagnosis all again without telling you. And then they come and say, nahi, just for meri tasalli ke liye mujhe jana hai. Then what do you do? Then let them first go into the detoxification, increase the immunity of their body, immunity levels of the body, and then let them go for the chemotherapy or the radiation. But in acupressure, we do number 16, we go in for all the points properly. And you will find that the diagnosis is 100% right and the symptoms will also be. But along with whatever you are going to tell, eat, drink, everything, I would suggest that it has worked wonders with my last lecture, or the same lecture I had last month also here. And those people have followed me up. There were three, four that were suffering. I did not know because they didn't tell in the class, but once they started following that, they said it made tremendous results in their body. So please put yourself in the hands of God. It has nothing to do that something like your karma. It has got nothing to do with karma. It has got everything to do with your mind. If you have kept something negative inside you, it manifests in some way or another. Cancer is a disease of I invite you into my body, into my mind. So don't ever say, I will never get. I have learned the hard lesson that way. No, you will get it. Because by saying no, I will not get it, it's a negative thought. No, I will not get it, it's a negative thought. If you do get it, I will teach it. We say that you want, you know, it's like when you want something from God, then you are on your knees and you are offering Him all the bribes possible and everything. He has given us 10 million things. How many times have you got up in the morning or gone to sleep in the night thanking Him for those things? But He's taken one thing away from you and you are a very person. Am I right or wrong? So instead of that, if all of us get together in the night, start from today, or give me a call after 1 week and tell me how you feel. If tonight, before you go to sleep, thank Him for the day. Thank Him that we were here today. That whatever little bit of knowledge you have got from me, that you will make use of it. And thank Him for everything, for your health, for whatever. He could have given you, instead of just giving you a small disease like cancer, he could have given you something bigger. Isn't it? What is worse than cancer is taking away your limbs, your eyesight, which you are absolutely dependent on somebody else. So don't you think we should thank Him for that? Thank Him that you are not stuck in the floods. And in the morning when you get up, you thank Him for having given you good night's sleep, for giving you a peaceful night. Maybe you didn't sleep the whole night, but it was peaceful. You were relaxed. You have a nice bed. You have a nice bedroom. How many times have you thought about doing that? And slowly, slowly, along with your treatment, you will find that whatever the disease is, do your treatment. Thank Him for everything. Yes, you can fight with Him. Like every Friday I am there in the minor OT at Tata's, and I see small, small children, 15 days, 1 month, and I just look at them and they die. You know, there was a week when I thought, was it because I looked at the child and the child died? So it happened like there was 1 dozen children that came to me, and I took the file, opened it, and I just cried. 100% of what I have told or the way I have treated that patient has helped that patient. That is also a great thing. So if you can get through it, and of course everybody goes on the net nowadays, if you do, you will find that it's very sad that in my country where we are supposed to be closer to God, we are going far away from our culture and our religion, and in the Western world, they are. I got an email from a friend of mine who comes in, but they are having the Hari Rama, Hari Krishna kind of house. And here I am, and we do nothing about that. So if we can incorporate that, prayers, thanking each other, if you have hurt somebody, how much will it cost you to go and say, I'm sorry? How much will it go and tell that person? I do it. That last time you made that comment, it hurt me very badly. Why did you do that? We do not communicate with each other. We don't. When I call you Lokesh, I only call it to give you gaalis, right? Or wo bolta bhi hai, aap gaali dete rehte ho jab bhi. Otherwise, I never call him to say, okay Lokesh, how's your day? What have you been doing today? Nothing. But now I've started that. I say, okay Lokesh, I'm coming for lunch and he doesn't come. So then gaali pati goes. I'm inviting him for lunch, he doesn't come, but it's like that. So how often have you actually gone up to a person and said, somebody very close to me hurt me very badly. I vowed that I will not talk to him. But I went and invited him for my daughter's wedding. I'm talking about my own father. I didn't speak to him for nearly 2 years. And he didn't remember what he had done. Yeah, he did. But I went and sat in front of him and he was Inspector General of Police. I said, you didn't remember? Unbelievable. Okay, sit, have to talk to you. So I told him, did I do that to you? He said, yeah, you did. Then I thought to myself, it was more than 2 years or 3 years. And I was burning inside because I love my father very much. I cannot live without him. And I'm not going to talk. Otherwise, I'm a Muslim and I love fish. So every time I would cook fish, this is my trick from Bengal. Every time I would cook fish, I would not give my family further. I would bring up the clock. In my house. The children come from school at that time. And my father would be there at 12:15. And now, till I made friends with them all again, I refused to cook fish in the house. Because I could not imagine eating fish without my father. So I made him without the fish. Now we are friends. Because all of them told me, no, you don't do this. He's your father. And I was shocked when the man turned around and said, impossible. I said, it's not. Then I explained that, and my youngest chacha, I called him also. You know, the thing of being told you're lying was so great in my head. So imagine the negative thinking that I had. So I had to call my chacha with me. Chacha, you were there, no? And Papa did this to me. Then my father said, Umar, I actually went to my daughter, and I'm the only daughter. My daughter, unbelievable. And then we both hug each other, right? And I said, you're coming for my daughter's wedding. He said, just try to stop me. So sometimes, and you won't believe it, from that day, if anybody has hurt me also, I have spoken. I spoke to him, correct? He hurt me very badly. I'm telling you in front of him, and I love him very much.
But I spoke to you first.
No. If I didn't want to talk to you, I would have put my phone on silent.
No, that's okay. I would bring up again.
I was so angry with him for doing that to me. And when I told him, he said it was just a normal conversation. I said, how can you talk